A new technological development is announced almost every day, and humanity has even reached the point of traveling into space. But while all this is happening, the depths of the seas still remain a mystery. While some research has been done in these places, little is known about what lies at the bottom of these bodies of water that cover most of the Earth. In this video, I explored some of the interesting creatures found in deep water. Don't forget to like the video. Let's go to our video. Found in the Indian and tropical Western Pacific Oceans, the peacock mantis shrimp is a candy-colored crustacean known for its ability to quickly punch prey with its front two appendages. According to Oceana, the International Ocean Preservation Advocacy Group, this shrimp's punch is one of the fastest movements in the animal kingdom, so much so that it's strong enough to break an aquarium's glass wall. But no worries, they mostly only use their fists of steel to break open mollusks and dismember crabs. This antisocial creature hides itself under rocks. Peacocks get their name from the colors of their bodies. They are hard-bodied, glowing with bright shades of red, green, orange, and blue, and their forearms are covered in spots. They feed on mollusks and small fish. Their lifespan is about 6 years. They carry their eggs in their chests for 40 days after they put them together with a special glue. Its name makes it sound like a piece of sexy lingerie, but don't be fooled. The pink see-through Fantasia is a sea cucumber found about 1.5 miles deep into the Celebes Sea in the Western Pacific, east of Borneo. It was only discovered a little over a decade ago, back in 2007, but the curious sea cucumber has a survival tactic that points to its long-time evolution, bioluminescence to ward off predators. The pink see-through Fantasia is named for its transparent skin, through which its mouth, anus, and intestines are all visible. It's so easy to miss the frogfish because these types of anglerfish, there are over 50 species of them, are nearly identical to their surroundings, mostly coral reefs. They resemble sponges or algae-covered rocks and come in pretty much every color and texture imaginable. Some frogfish even use their camouflage not to hide, but rather to mimic poison sea slugs. No matter their appearance, one thing all species of frogfish have in common is their strange mode of locomotion. Although they can swim, most walk along their pectoral fins, which have evolved into arm-like limbs, including a joint that resembles an elbow. Usually seen nestled into burrows around coral reefs, the ribbon eel, sometimes called the leaf-nosed moray eel, lives in Indonesian waters from East Africa to southern Japan, Australia, and French Polynesia. The juveniles start out black, with a pale yellow strip along the fins, and as they grow, transitions to a bright blue and yellow coloring. These eels are considered protrandic hermaphrodites, meaning they change sex from male to female several times throughout their lives. Found in the Atlantic and Pacific Oceans, this species of shark is one of the most widely known living fossils. It can live up to 1,500 meters deep in the oceans, but is mostly found at depths of 50 to 200 meters. These creatures, which are 2 meters tall, have a dark brown color, which is thought to be characteristics of their ancestors. It has an eel-like body plan and dorsal, pelvic, and anal fins that are set well back compared to its other cousins. It also has 6 gill slits instead of 5, unlike the majority of sharks today. It is known that gill slits in sharks start with 7 slits, first decreasing to 6 and then to 5. Today, there are around 400 species with 5 gill slits. There are 6 species with 6 gill slits and only 1 species with 7 gill slits. Moreover, this species has a very primitive structure in terms of behavior. For example, in a way that has never been observed in any shark species to date. It stretches itself back like a snake, shoots forward like an arrow, and jumps on its prey. Normally, such attack behavior is not observed in sharks. Similarly, its gestation is extremely long. It can last up to 3.5 years, a record for any known vertebrate. They can give birth to 2 to 15 young at a time, and the species does not have a specific breeding season. They can breed at any time. Scientists found this strange creature at the Great Barrier Reef's Lizard Island and named it, aptly, the Christmas tree worm. The spiral branches are actually the worm's breathing and feeding apparatuses, while the worm itself lives in a tube. These tree-like crowns are covered in hair-like appendages called radioles. These are used for breathing and catching prey, but they can be withdrawn if the Christmas tree worm feels threatened. Like many other marine creatures, the box crab is a master of disguise. In this case, crustaceans that mostly remain on the seabed are. They bury themselves under the sand so that only their eyes stick out from the muddy depths. One of the most fascinating aspects of the box crab's life cycle is mating habits that literally redefine what it means to be swept off your feet. When the male box crab finds his mate, he grabs her in his claws and carries her across the seafloor until she sheds her shell. Researchers with the Census of Marine Zooplankton first discovered the squidworm in 2007 during a cruise in a remotely operated vehicle some 1.8 miles underwater. The funky-looking fish is named for the 10 appendages protruding from its head, which look like tentacles. The squidworm uses these to collect debris falling from the open waters above, known as marine snow. These guys are native to Chile, deep waters, and can grow to be quite large. In 2010, a remotely operated underwater vehicle discovered a giant isopod measuring 2.5 feet. These crustaceans, which sort of resemble a massive woodworm, are carnivores and usually feed on dead animals that fall down from the ocean's surface. Despite their discovery back in 1879, these creatures mostly remain a mystery. However, it's believed that giant isopods grow so large in order to withstand the pressure at the bottom of the sea. With over 3,000 different species on record, the nudibranch is an extremely versatile kind of sea slug. These little guys are found pretty much everywhere in both shallow and deep waters from the north and south poles and into the tropics. There are two distinct kinds, dorid nudibranch, which are smooth with feather-like gills on their back to help them breathe, and eelid nudibranch, which breath through a different kind of organ also located on their backs called cerata. Because the tiny nudibranch lacks a shell, it instead protects itself with bright camouflage meant as a warning signal. But perhaps their wildest adaptation of all is the ability to quite literally swallow, digest, and reuse stinging cells from prey. The sea angel is a species most commonly seen in the passive ocean. The sea angel has various characteristics. Their average height is 1.52 centimeters. Sea angels live at greater depths. Sea angels reproduce in an ovoviviparous manner. Their eggs develop inside the body. They spawn new sea angels ranging from 6 to 10 at a time. It is mostly seen on the west coasts of South America and North America. Sea angels are a species that lives 200 meters deep in the ocean. The gulper eel, also referred to as the pelican eel, is named for its massive mouth and jaw, which helps them to swallow prey whole. They can grow up to 6 feet in length, and their huge mouths allow them to hunt down meals that are larger than them. This usually happens when food is scarce. It's believed that gulper eels usually eat crustaceans and other small marine animals. This is the end of the video. I found these species as a result of research, and they surprised me a lot. If you want the second part of the video to come, don't forget to like, share, and comment on the video. Goodbye for now.